Now see,
type your desired username in the text box and click next. So now your task is to type the username in the text box and click next. It would automatically fix up the computer name. Next is, if you want to set the password, type it in the text box and click next. It's up to you. If you want to set the password, type a password and retype the same password that you have typed in the password column and type a password hint. It's for your reference, because after 1 year, 2 years, if you forget the password and you know little bit hint about password, then it's easier to recover. Next is, type your product key in the text box. This is the text box of product key. You just need to insert it into the product key text box. You can also skip this step and simply click next if you want to type the product key later. Now it's up to you. You can either insert that product key when you are installing the Windows, and or you can even insert it after 30 days. It's up to you. Click on the next. Select your desired option for Windows update. So it's up to you how you want to update your computer system. Select time and click next. Now it's up to you. You have to select the time and date accordingly. If you are connected to any network, it will ask you to set the network location. If you are connected with Wi-Fi or you are connected with some other network, you have to select the options accordingly. Now Windows is finalizing your settings. Now it's finalizing your setting means what the language you have choose, what the network, what the time, username, everything that we have done is now finalizing. Now this is the welcome screen of the Windows. Welcome screen. Preparing your desktop. Many times we have seen this message, preparing your desktop. This is setting up personalized settings for our Windows desktop update. It's a personalized setting. It's completely depend upon you. You want to set up any setting like browser customizations, and there you have fresh copy of Windows 7 installed. Now this is now desktop of Windows 7. This is the image how the Windows 7 look like. This is the Windows 7 operating system. Now, firstly, you should install the drivers on your PC. After the Windows is installed, you just need to install the drivers on your PC. Check whether properly installed the drivers file. Now, if you want to see drivers are installed or not, you just need to check it. The drivers by computer, right click on this computer, go to the manage and go to the device manager. First, you go to the computer, right click on the computer, go to the manage and go to the device manager. See the yellow color mark? It means should install drivers. This yellow color marks means it is should install drivers. So if we know that we have to install the driver according to the devices. So first you need to go to the computer, right click on this, go to the manage, and you click on the manage, go to the device manager. So these are the steps. How can we install the Windows 7 operating system on your computer? Next topic is, what is troubleshooting of memory? Means if we have any type of problem in a case of memory, how can we troubleshoot it? It means if we have any type of trouble, then how can we shoot it? So this topic is dealing with how can we troubleshoot of memory. Means if we have any type of a memory, then how can we solve it or how can we manage it? So troubleshooting is the process of diagnosing the source of the problem. It means we have to find the reason of the problem, source of problem. It is used to fix the problems. We have to fix the problem. We can fix it with the hardware. We can fix it with the software or many other products. So computer memory problem is generally caused by defective memory chips. Computer memory problem arises when we have a defective memory chip or we install the memory chip in a wrong way or we have done the wrong configuration of memory chips. So basically, this is the topic named as troubleshooting of memory. It means how can we troubleshoot of memory? It means if any problem arises related to memory, how can we shoot it? How can we clear it? So troubleshooting means we have to find out the main root cause or main source of the problem from where it is arising. In case of memory, the problems maybe arises if we are using defective memory chips, it is a damaged memory chips, and we install the memory chip in the wrong way, we don't know the right procedure. And let us suppose I'm just inserting the RAM chip into the memory chip of motherboard and I don't know how to install it, but still I'm trying, it will create a problem of memory. And other is that wrong configuration of memory chips, I don't want to configure the motherboard, but still I'm working to create again problem related to memory. So we have our memory related problems. Now task is how to solve it, how to troubleshoot it. Common memory problems. We have common memory problems. First is improper configurations. First, it means you have wrong part of your computer, did not follow the configuration rules. I just want to configure, but I don't know how to configure it. But still, I'm trying it. It will create a memory problem. Improper installation. I don't know how to install the RAM. I don't know where is a memory chip, where is a RAM slot. But still, I'm trying. It will create a problem. Defective hardware. Let us suppose that memory module is defective, then how can we accept it will work perfectly? So these are some of the common memory problems. Basic troubleshooting. This is how can we solve the memory problems. First is that make sure you have the right memory part for your computer system. Second, configure your memories correctly configured. So make it confirm it, make it show that you have done the perfect configuration of your memory. Third is, if any memory module is defective, reinstall it. Fourth is, swap the modules, means interchange the modules. If one module is not fit into one place, just change it with another module. Last is, clean the socket and pin on the memory module. So clean the socket where you want, there is your memory chip, and pin on the memory module. So these are the basic troubleshootings. So first is, make sure you have the right memory part of your computer system. This is very important. At the manufacturer website, you can look up the part number. Many memory manufacturers have configurations which indicate the compatibilities of your module. If not, phone the memory manufacturer or refer to the computer manual. It means when we go to the market and I just want to purchase the charger of a laptop named laptop, I have purchased of company Dell. I have to purchase the charger according to my laptop. It means I have to select the right part of my computer. I'm working on a Dell laptop. I cannot purchase the charger of Lenovo, or I cannot buy the charger of HP laptop. So make it sure always choose the right either a memory part or any part of your computer system. Next is, confirm that you configured the memory correctly. Many computers require module installation in banks of equal capacity modules. Some computers require highest capacity modules. Some require lowest capacity modules. So always try to understand first what are the requirements for your computer system. If your computer is working on a 64-bit memory, it has some different requirements. If it's working on a 128 memory, then it has a different requirements. So make it so that you configure the memory very correctly. If it is not configured correctly, it will automatically give the memory problems. Next is, reinstall the module. If you found any module of your memory is defective and defected and damaged, you just need to reinstall the module. So the module that is problematic and the module that is defected, push it on from the socket and reinstall the new module so that it will work properly. Swap modules. Now remove the new memory and see whether the problem disappears. if you have reinstalled the new and you know that again it is creating a problem, your task is to remove the new memory. Now see, problem is there or not. Remove the old memory, reinstall the new and see whether the problem persists. Try the memory in different software. It means first, if you feel that your old memory is creating a problem, swap it with the new memory. But again, if you feel that your new memory is again creating a problem, swap it with old memory. So this is called as swapping. And your swapping will go until and unless you have to troubleshoot the memory problem. Let us suppose that problem is there. I have tried with the new memory. Same problem is there. I have tried with old memory. Same problem is there. It means there is a problem. So you have to make a solution. Next is clean the socket and pins on the memory module. Use soft clothes to wipe the pins on the module. Use PC rectum or compressed air to blow dust off the socket. Do not use solvent which may corrode the metal or prevent the leads from making full contact. Flux soap is a cleaner used especially for the contacts. So you can purchase it in electronics or computer retail store. So it's your responsibility to clean the sockets and the pins that is available on the memory module. Next is update the BIOS, basic input output system. So computer manufacturers update BIOS frequently so that you can continue their work with a good performance. Make sure you have the recent BIOS on your computer system, and this applies especially when you have recently installed new software or you are significantly upgrading memory. So it's very important to update your BIOS. Let us suppose that I am working on a Windows 7. Now I am upgrading Windows 7 with Windows 10. It's very compulsory and important to upgrade your BIOS. When the problem occurs, means what are the areas and what is the time period, or when there is the chances that problem will occur related to the memory chips. It could be occur when we have bought a new computer. Second, if we installed the memory recently. Third, we have installed new software or maybe a new operating system. Either we have installed or new hardware. Your computer has been running fine and you have made two other recent changes. So these are the areas or a time period when the problem arises. Maybe when we purchase new computer, new memory, and new software installed, new operating system is installed, maybe we have installed new hardware and the previous one, there will be a chances of troubleshooting of memory and still be computer serving correctly fine, but we are not making any type of updates or changes. So this is when the problem arises. You have bought a new computer. So if you have just purchased a new computer and it is producing memory errors, the problem could be related to anything. Maybe I have purchased the computer and still I'm start working on it and it's creating a memory errors or memory problems. Then what was the reason of the problem? It may be a bad computer board. It may be anything. In this case, you need to troubleshoot the entire computer system including memory. We have to troubleshoot the full computer. We know that there will be a problem in the memory, but we have to diagnose or troubleshoot the whole computer. Because the computer dealer will have to put the memory and run system just before shipping, they can be tested. So maybe chances are there when we have to test the new computer, there will be chances of memory errors. Next, when we install a new memory, there will be another chance. When we have installed a new memory, there will be a chances of memory errors. Maybe it is not compatible with the old memory chips. So any type of problem arises. Maybe we are not installed it or configured it properly. Next, you have installed new software or operating system. Another reason is that maybe we have installed new operating system or new software. In both situations, there will be a chances you will get the memory errors. Let us suppose previously I'm working on Windows 7 and still I'm upgrading it with the Linux operating system. So maybe there will be a chances of memory errors. I have installed a new software. Maybe this software is not compatible with my computer system. Again, it will generate a memory error. You have installed or removed hard drive. Let us suppose we have installed new software that is not compatible with computer system, or we have removed the software. Maybe for installation or for moving the hardware, there could be a chances of memory error. Unexpected problems. If your system has been running fine, we are working on it, it's working accordingly, there is no problem. But suddenly it start or it produce a memory errors, maybe a crash or lockup frequency, the chances of hard failure is more likely, since configuration and installation problems show up as soon as computer download. So sometimes you get the memory problems. If your computer is overheating, this is one of the problem. If you are having problem with your power supply, then there will be your chances of memory error. So lots of reasons we have when we get the memory errors. Next is handling specific problems. Here is the list of most common ways the computer informs you of the memory problems. When any type of memory problem arises in the computer system, computer also gives signals or indicate to its user there will be a chances of memory error. So first signal is the computer would not boot, it beeps very slowly. So one of the signal is that when there is a memory problem, the computer start beeping. It don't be boot. Computer boots but does not recognize all the installed memory. Computer is still booting, but it does not recognize the memory that is installed. Third is that computer boot, but the screen is completely blank. Operating system is not loaded into RAM. Computer reports a memory error. First is memory mismatch error may occur. Memory parity impact may be occur. Memory address error. Memory failure errors. Memory verify errors. So these are the various errors that is related to memory error. Computer has some other problems that will be caused by memory. First, it crashes frequently. There will be a registry error, general production faults, page faults start arising, exception errors. The last is the server system manager report on memory error. So we have there is a memory error, the computer start indicating its user by giving the critical signals. It start beeping, don't boot. And when it boot, but the screen is completely black, so we can easily understand there will be a problem of memory. First is that computer would not boot. When there is a memory error, computer stop booting and it starts beeping. Every time the computer starts, it takes inventory of hardware. Inventory means it takes stock of the hardware. So inventory consists of when you switch on the computer. And inventory consists of BIOS, basic input output recognizing, acknowledging, and some cases assigning address to the components in the computer system. So if computer would not boot, the CPU is unable to communicate with hardware. So booting is very important for computer, because when computer boot, it gets the control over BIOS, it gets the control over addresses. But if computer don't boot, then it means CPU is not able to communicate with hardware. And the main reason of this problem is that improper installation or failure of BIOS to recognize the hardware. So follow basic troubleshooting, paying good attention or special attention to whether the memory module is completely installed and that you have the latest version of BIOS. So when you feel your computer is not booting, it's still beeping, it means there will be a chances of memory error. So your task is to pay a specific attention to this problem and get rid from it as soon as possible. So booting is not a normal thing. Booting means when your computer boot, it will get the control over everything. BIOS, acknowledging, assigning addresses. If it is not boot, CPU cannot be communicate with hardware. Next is computer boot but does not recognize all the installed memory. This is another problem. Now computer is booting, not beeping, but still it is not recognizing whether it has a memory or not. So when computer boots, it gets control over everything. On some machines, the count appears on the screen and On others, it is masked. If the count is masked from the computer setup menu, see how much memory the computer thinks it has. So sometimes computer will recognize only part of the module. This is almost always due to the using wrong kind of memory. For example, if computer accepts only single bank memory and you have installed a dual bank memory, I have a dual chip, but computer is still recognizing only a single chip. This is one of the problem. The computer will read only half of the memory. Full memory is not read by the computer. Only the half module of the memory is only read by the computer. So this is one of the problem. So computer is booting, but it is not catching the full memory. Let us suppose that we have installed a dual memory, but computer is only recognizing the single memory. Rest of the memory is not recognized by computer. The computer boot, but screen is blank. Yes, computer is booting, but screen is blank. There will be no loading. There will be no loading of desktop, no loading of operating system. I switch on the computer, but it boot, but nothing. Screen is completely black. My desktop is not shown to me. The computer reports a memory error, memory mismatch error. This is one of the problem that arises, memory mismatch error. This is actually not an error. Some computer require you to tell that it's okay to have a new amount of memory. Use the setup menu to tell the computer. So basically it's not error. It problem, this type of problem arises when we are inserting new chips or new RAM into old chips. So there will be a chances of memory mismatch. Computer memory or address errors may be like memory parity interrupt, memory address error, memory failure error, memory verification error. So these are some of the problems that we have to face. Next problem is the server system manager report a memory error. This is one of the thing. Now the server system manager reporting the memory error, we have to correct it. So this is one of the memory error that is reported by server system manager. We have a server system. Server is a system that get the request from the client, process it and send the result back to the client. This is called a server system. And if there will be any problem arises, then it's also start reporting a memory error. The computer system has some other problems that will be caused by memory. It may be have a registry errors, it may be have a general production faults, page faults, and exception errors. First is a registry errors. Window write a large portion of registry to memory. So window every time write a large portion of registry to RAM, to main memory. Sometime defective memory will cause a registry error when window report a registry error and prompt you to restart and restore. If the prompt repeat, remove your newly installed memory and restart the computer. So it means every time when window write the registry to RAM, but if your memory chip is defective, if the memory chip is problematic, then it will start creating the problem. We are not able to write the registry to the RAM. So if you are working on a new RAM, new memory, you just need to remove and restart the computer. If you feel the problem is not now there, ask the memory manufacturer for replacement modules. So registry error means window write registry to RAM, and when window writing the registry to RAM, it will feel memory error, like it's not able to be do the work properly. So in this case, you just need to restart and restore it. Next is general production faults, page fault, and exception errors. The most common cause is software. For example, one application may have not released the memory after quitting or occupies the same memory address as another. Rebooting should solve the problem if the computer suddenly displays general production faults, exception errors. Let us suppose that one transaction is using two resources. Now the transaction is completed, but still it don't release the resources. The resources is currently handled by the transaction, but transaction is still idle. It has done its work. Again, it will create a problem because a new transaction always think that resources is busy with the previous one, but the previous one is it idle. Previous one is not still currently working on our resources. So this is one of the main problem. So you have to install the new memory, or even you can remove the new memory to see whether the error stopped or not. It's all our memory related errors. So you just need to take care of all the parameters or factors that we have discussed in today's class.